on. I think we have to. Sons of Anarchy, really good show. And
we gotta finish the last season first, though.
I honestly think it's better than Walking Dead, and that comment has come across a couple times. But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about a young woman.
Yeah, let's get back to the
that sings called Katie Sagal, and you all know her as Peggy Bundy.
Huh.
This woman has a beautiful voice to her, and she's almost knocking Jewel out of my favorite female singers, and we know how much I think of Jewel, so that'll tell you right there that
boyhood fantasies, people.
No boyhood fantasies for Katie anymore. Beautiful singer, but age has gotten her big time. She could probably play Grandma.
All things considered, she still looks good when she has the skinny jeans on.
Yeah, but she definitely could play Grandma Gruley on Superman. He could be Darkseid's little sidekick there. And we were talking about Batman versus Superman, in case you have not heard. And, of course, the new movie, Superman versus Batman.
Yeah, if they're listening to your show, they've heard.
And
it's Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice, according to the...
Dawn of Justice.
I don't even like the subtitle of... I don't even like the... What was it? The subtitle? Is that the word?
Yeah.
Dawn of... That stupid. It's stupid.
Yeah. You know what it's doing. And then if you're listening, everybody out there already knows what they're doing. They're getting ready to...
the Justice League?
Yeah. Getting ready to launch the Justice League to compete with the Avengers. Will it do well? I don't know. I'll tell you one thing that I was a little shocked and disappointed on is the fact that they're not using any of the actors that are already established as DC characters off the CW show.
Yeah, and these actors really have honed in the characters.
I mean, I don't see anybody else playing Flash better than the dude that's playing him right now.
Exactly. The guy that plays Green Arrow does it very well. He's been doing it for
years. And Green Arrow's all right, but he's not really a main character in the Justice League.
No.
I mean, he's a pop-up guy here and there, but he's not a main Justice League character. However, the Flash is. And the character that's playing him does a really good job. He's young. He's hungry. And I really wish they had brought him into this movie.
Yeah, it'd be nice to see him on the big screen because he really does it well enough.
Okay, so what you're saying is we're starting this whole thing off with a bunch of nobodies playing roles that have already been done well by others.
Yes. Right, except for the famous Ben.
Ben Affleck.
Affleck, which this is what brings up.
I can hear gagging going on all across the audio and radio listening audience right now.
This brings up much hatred in the world of Batman, and I don't understand it. I don't see it yet. Okay, the guy's not the greatest actor, but the dude that originally played the first Batman out of Tim Burton's not the best actor either.
Michael Keaton,
and he did a pretty damn good job of pulling
Michael
that off.
Michael Keaton's Batman.
So, guys, give this guy a chance. It hasn't even come out yet, and you're tearing him apart before you even see the movie. If it sucks afterwards, by all means.
Tear the man apart after.
Yeah, but I'm going to tell you this right now. You better get used to it, because he signed on for 7 to 8 contracts playing Batman.
Well, I guess we know he's not going to die at the end of Superman versus
Batman
then.
And in 7 to 8 of these, 3 of him, he's written himself, and he's going to be producing himself.
He's a die-hard Batman freak.
Well, yeah, I mean, now, hard-hearted as I am probably going to be toward this movie, that is enough to make me say, okay, let's see what he does.
Right.
I mean, this guy...
He has passion.
Yeah, that counts for a lot.
Yeah.
So, all right, let's see what he does. I would rather start tearing apart this movie on other grounds, which is not having seen it, but that's not going to stop me. What kind of stupid concept, you start off with the two main characters, right? The two biggest names in the Justice League fighting, in a versus situation to kick off a Justice League franchise. How stupid is that? I mean, you're supposed to, if you want to see how to do it right, you watch Marvel's Avengers. That's how you do it right. You introduce the other characters.
Give them their own movies.
You give them their own movie, give them their own props, and then bring it together afterwards. Yeah. Obviously,
you know already how this is starting. This is going to be the world's biggest tease job that you've ever seen. You're not going to get a whole movie of Batman and Superman slobbering it out and kicking the crap out of each other.
Oh, no. There's going to be like a half hour fight scene. Half hour? A 2.5 hour movie.
No, it's going to be like a WCW wrestling show.
Yeah, it'll be like 10 minutes. You're done.
If that.
I was trying to be hopeful. No. Stop being the dream crushers that
you
are.
3 minutes and with an inconclusive ending.
Right. You're not going to get a fight that's going to keep going on. I mean, you already see what they're bringing in.
Well,
unfortunately, if you didn't see the commercial to this during Thanksgiving or any of the ones that are up on YouTube, you didn't see how they're turning Doomsday into Doomsday, which as a comic fan, I look at it and say, oh, man, that's totally out in left field. But it's their movie, so they can do what they want. Not going to ruin it. If you haven't seen it, watch
the
trailer. It shows you how it's coming to be. And then they show spoilers of boom tubes opening up, and you see Darkseid's little minions flying around in the air. So you know there's going to be a whole lot of
team-up stuff.
Yeah, and Lex Luthor. This
As if we need another movie with Lex Luthor in it.
Now, this is the part that pisses me off.
I'm already pissed off. Go ahead.
Looking at this kid that is playing him, he looks like he's 12 years younger than Batman and Superman combined.
He's so baby face, it's not even
All right, I'm looking at this character. Now is he... what age is he supposed to be in the movie?
I don't know. I haven't seen what age he's supposed to be. I haven't really catched into that.
It seems like usually in the comic realm, he has at least 10 to 20 years on Superman.
Yeah, he's older than him. He's already been established.
Yeah.
Because
he's a tycoon.
In the comic worlds, he's
like
makes...
the Donald Trump of...
Right, but in the comic worlds, he makes remarks to Bruce Wayne about working with his father.
Exactly.
So that would mean he was older than Batman and Superman, and they just totally said, no, we're not doing that. We're making it as this young kid.
Which is...
And it's out of the world of the comic. And I don't... And normally, you guys know how I feel about this, but that's stupid. That right there is enough to crush a movie.
And now, if you want, now other stupid things are now Darkseid, right?
Yep.
In other words, what they're doing is instead of a build up to the Justice League, what they're doing is they're throwing it all at you, like
it's going to be a slap together.
Crap! It's like throwing all crap at the wall, see what sticks, and they're going to throw all these characters at you all at once so they can sell a bunch of action figures.
Yep.
And It's going to be, like I say, WCW, the defunct and unlamented wrestling organization, is what this movie project reminds me most of. I mean, and the awful part of it is we've seen it done right.
Yeah.
We've seen it, Superman versus Batman done right in Frank Miller's Dark Knight comics.
Yep.
It's been done.
The story already.
The story is written. You can't improve on that storyline.
Turn that into a movie.
Yes. I mean, it's got everything in it. You can't improve on it.
Add some dialogue.
Well, no, there's word balloons in the comic. You just say those words.
They'll probably need a little bit more to fill that two and a half hour gap.
It's easy to say that George Garner definitely hates everything about this right now. So let's go down to...
I'm going to be a prophet. I'm using the gift of psychic prophecy here to say that I'm going to hate this movie.
I think we all will to some extent.
And like I said, but that is my bigger prophecy, is that everybody in the cinema at all times will hate it.
And if Donald Trump, if you are listening, this goes out to you. I Hate Everything About You by Ugly Kid Joe here on Chuckles Crypt, Rhode Island Free Radio.
Are you the guys on the beach who hate everything? Is this some sort of hip music that I don't understand? We'll be right back.
Hate everything about everybody. That's going to be my song because I am an evil clown and I do hate everything about everybody. That's a good thing. Lenny Joe, if you're out there listening, put on your Superman tighty whities and your Batman tighty whities and fight. I want you to record this and see who the winner is. That's my shout out to you guys.
Not the stained ones.
No stained ones. And I don't want them drawn on with magic markers. Either. And if you say you heard this from my show, I'll deny it, and we will erase all evidence. So we're into fighting. We are. And St. Patrick's Day is around the corner.
Yep.
And this is perfect. Batman versus Superman. Now, I heavily enjoy the book series, the comic book series. I even sport a wedding ring with the symbol of Batman versus Superman.
Sorry, which series, though?
The Dark Knight.
The Dark Knight. Okay, good.
Still on my fingers, see? I sport it. And I dig through books to find these things because they're usually in the 50 cents one and get excited when I see them. And it has always been one of my favorite verses. And the hard part about this is I'm a bigger Batman fan than I am Superman. And I'm pretty sure that the folks around the table feel the same way. Superman is great. He is the first real big, not saying the first comic character, but first real big comic character that is Americana. But as much as I love Batman, let's do the educational part here, folks. And I know you're going to, and you're right, George will say you're going to take different genres, and you could. But even with every different genre, I did the bad versus the good, Superman would kick the living crap out of Batman. It doesn't matter if it was the action hero comics or the now comics, he would plaster him onto a wall.
Yeah, the only way that he wouldn't would be if we go back to the original Superman, which they're not going to do, back from like Action Comics number one. You know, and even then, it would be a bit of a mismatch.
I said the same thing. Even going back to Action Comics, he still has his speed and his super strength.
But
he can't
fly originally.
No, but he can jump just as high.
Jump, yeah.
And he would still be able to smash the living crap out of Batman.